out of 10 cats does countdown. John Richardson, Sean Luck, Vic Reeves, Bob Mortimer, Jack Whitehall, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy
to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, each animal has its own specific mating call? A badger shrieks, a fox clickets, a goat rattles, a deer croons and a Jimmy begs. The average American eats 28 pigs in a lifetime. Sorry, that should read, in a lunchtime. And on average, it takes 7 minutes to fall asleep. Here's a little tip if you're having trouble falling asleep. Why not ask my girlfriend what sort of a day she had? Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up is Sean Luck. Sean's brilliantly funny, can hold his drink and handle himself in a fight. In short, he's someone you always want on your side. Unless you're playing Countdown. Joining Sean tonight is Vic Reeves.
Hi, Sean. Thank you.
With his offbeat jokes and sideways view of the world, Vic manages to tread a fine line between avant-garde surrealism and getting himself sectioned.
Yeah, that's what they said.
Up against them this evening is John Richardson. With his award-winning stand-up, high-profile TV career and best-selling DVDs, it's surprising just how boring John genuinely is.
No one's coming back at you, are they, Jimmy? Is that the way it works?
That's the way. Well, oh, right, come back in a minute. We do these, and then you could come back.
Okay. No, I wasn't actually interested.
John's teammate this evening is Bob Mortimer. Before becoming a comedian, Bob used to work as a probation officer, so I'm assuming you and Sean go way back.
What is this thing about me in fights? I don't get in fights.
He was on probation for running a brothel, actually.
Yeah, my brothel.
John used.
I dressed him up.
I was enjoying that until then.
That's what he said when the police walked in. okay. Can I just say, it is great to have Vic and Bob on the show together, isn't it? Yeah. Amazing.
Yeah. I've just noticed that Bob's here tonight. How are you doing? All right, nice to see you. I've seen you for ages.
Bob, are you a competitive kind of person?
No, I don't think so, not really. I mean, I've never scored a point on this show, for example. Doesn't mean I'm not trying.
Do you think it'll change tonight?
Have you been... Yeah, I do, because I'm on John's team. Yeah, it's the first time I've been with John.
Yeah, it's good being with John. John is good at Countdown.
Isn't it, though?
Yeah.
And he got lovely hair as well, close up. From a distance, I don't know. Close up, beautiful.
It is luxurious hair, isn't it? It's almost
isn't
like...
it, though?
It's quite Persian. Look at these two here, with the strong Persian hair.
Mine's actually this colour, though.
Yeah, but Jimmy's isn't pubes.
You do appear to have pubic hair, that is...
It does slightly, but I'm one of the few people who can find a hair that shape in his food and think, oh, that's all right, actually.
What do you see when you look in the mirror, John?
Oh, well, tonight I'll see pubes and someone fleeing from a brothel.
Could I come on your team?
What's your idea of a romantic evening?
On my own or with someone?
Well, ideally with someone, I suppose.
Bella Pasta. On my own, nice bath, few bubbles, glass of wine, film, lovely. Put my special mitten on.
Oh, that's why there's a film in the bath here.
Vic, what do you think Bob's biggest weakness is going to be this evening?
Well, he's a very strong man, so I can't think of any weaknesses that he's got. I know he's... Do you know Humpback Bridges? they generally find that if you look at him, yeah. they build them over his back. They get him to crouch down and strain, and then just that build over it until it's hardened. Then he crawls off. That's how they make humpback bridges. He's a very powerful man, got a lot of strengths.
Sean, a present company accepted. Who would be your dream celebrity partner on Cats Does Countdown?
I would like the best person to have would be Sepp Blatter, because I'd definitely win. In fact, there'd be no point playing the game. We'd have already won. We could all go to the pub.
Sepp Blatter. Is he a pop singer?
He's the head of FIFA.
Is he?
Yeah.
Oh, well, I've never heard of them. Who are they?
FIFA. They're a bit like Kasabian.
Oh, well, that sounds that, then.
OK, so, John, do you have a mascot this evening?
Not really. I'm a bit annoyed, Jimmy, to be here this week, actually, cos tonight's supposed to be my hen night, cos I'm getting married.
Stag night, I think, is what you mean to say.
Come again.
You just said it was your hen night tonight.
Yes.
Stag night.
With a right laugh. I emailed all my friends. All working, would you believe? Yeah. All working, all of them. So I've been out on my own.
Do you get invited on a lot of stag do's?
Yeah. I've been on a few. I tend to nip back early. You have to share rooms on stag do's, so I find if I get back early, I can have the key changed and then I get a good night's sleep. I don't get invited on a lot of stag do's, Jimmy.
I went on a stag do in Manchester, in this fine city.
What happened?
I went to Vodka Revolutions. Very good, set up for stag do's. It's the only kind of place you go to where they have drinks offers like buy two Jaeger bombs, get the morning after pill for free. we should go there after the show this evening.
Definitely, I don't want to get pregnant again. have you got a mascot?
Yes, I have. Would you like to see it, Jimmy?
Yes.
I'll present it to you. It's a little drawing of dog dirt that my son did. And it's the first one he did, which he actually named it Dog Dirt. I think, personally think, that dog dirt is quite a lucky thing. I always pick one up if I see one. For dog dirt.
How old is Tom?
Well, he's 17 now.
But this was done 2 years ago.
And that was his O-level project.
A-star. Vic, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I have. Hang on a minute.
What are you doing?
He's undressing. Oh, Jesus.
Wow.
God.
I always have my lucky pants with me.
Doesn't look like you've had a lot of luck in them, to be honest.
Well, they've brought me a lot of luck in the past. Jack,
imagine the state of your trousers if you haven't been wearing them.
Shall I try them on?
Oh, look! Oh, don't put them on your trousers. All them all dirtied up.
Sort of Superman's granddad.
I committed to it, and they're slightly damp.
Okay, Sean, have you got a mascot?
Well, I've got a mascot. Is I just remembered recently that in 1973, when I was 10, I buried a time capsule, and I had a bit of a knock on the head, and I suddenly remembered where it was buried, which was in the grave of one of my first victims. So I went back and I dug it up and I thought tonight would be a good opportunity to open it up and see... surprisingly easy. Now, I remember that year for Christmas, I got a £5 note. That's how big they were. Remember them?
Yes, yes.
God, and the big wallet you needed. Now that's what I call music too. The government's Eat One A Day campaign leaflet. People couldn't believe it when it came out, suggesting that you should have one piece of fruit or vegetables a day, and it never caught on, still hasn't, I don't think. And then there was... I wrote down a list... Oh, my God! Oh, Jesus! That's what happened to to Hammy. He must have... got in the box just before I closed the lid. We wondered what happened. I could take those posters down now.
There we go.
And if there was a list, I wrote a list of things I hated. It'd be interesting to see if I still hate them.
Yeah, I wonder.
ABBA. Yeah. Still hate ABBA. Maths and spelling. Yeah, still hate that. Prosecco. I hated Prosecco when I was 10. I'll drink it, but... only if there's nothing else. Girls. And I don't hate girls anymore. It's women now.
OK, over in Dictionary Corner, it's Jack Whitehall. Privately educated 20-something, Jack Whitehall is a versatile actor, playing anything from a privately educated 20-something in Fresh Meat to a 20-something who's been privately educated in Bad Education.
Next one.
That's it. Are you good at Countdown? Are you any good at the actual game?
Jimmy Carr has a laugh that sounds like a seal pup being raped by a group of Eskimos.
True. Are you a Countdown fan, Jack? Do you like the show?
I love Countdown. It's a British institution.
Yeah.
It's like Doctor Who. Every, like, couple of years, the main guy dies and then is regenerated with another white man. That's how it works.
Were you good at maths and English at school?
No. I was more into sort of art and drama. Shock horror. So this evening I thought, okay, if it was possible, that I would turn Dictionary Corner into more sort of artist's corner and I could be the artist in residence. Because I brought along some materials and I thought over the course of the evening I would sketch you like one of my French girls. Is that okay with you?
I would love to be one of your French girls.
So if you just carry on as you are normally with the show,
right,
and I will, over the course of the evening, get drawing.
It's a lovely idea. And with Jack is, of course, Susie Dent. Our resident lexicographer, Susie, lived in New York for 2 years. They say New York is the city that never sleeps. Well, it did when Susie was there talking about lexicography. Now, do people ever try and show off when they're speaking to you and use, you know, longer words just to sort of try and impress you? Use lots of sesquipedalian sort of words.
Very good.
I'm in there.
They'd have to use hippopotamus monstro sesquipedalian, which is monstrously long words.
Ultra microscopic silico volcanic herniosis.
Very good.
Well, you know.
Yeah, he's in too.
Back off, Carl.
Is that a railway station in Wales?
I can do the railway station.
So can I.
Oh, well, let's have both of you, railway station in Wales. 3, 2, 1.
Cardiff Central.
Could you give us the full... what's the full Welsh longest name, place name in the UK? OK, and in charge of the numbers is Rachel Riley. Rachel joined Countdown in January 2009 after Carol Vorderman sadly broke her leg and had to be shot and melted down for glue. Rachel, present company accepted. Who's your idol? Who do you most look up to?
Well, actually, I'd go for Susie. I think Susie's awesome. She's a working mum. She knows every word imaginable except anything vaguely rude. She's gorgeous and she's really good at arm wrestling.
You're good at arm wrestling?
I love arm wrestling.
Well, let's get the guns out.
Maybe later. You've missed out a mole there.
Oh.
I've seen you wrestle Nick Hewitt and Jeff Stelling.
What, at the same time?
It sounds like you walked in on something and they made up an excuse. And you... No, we were just arm wrestling. And... OK, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Swing Ball Set. What an awesome display of sporting excellence.
Could the two chaps and Jimmy reenact the Jeff Stelling, Nick Hewer, Susie Dennis?
Thank you very much indeed, fellas. The Countdown Swing Ball Set.
Thank you.
OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. John and Bob, you get the first pick of the letters.
Please.
Can I have a vowel, please?
Thank you, Bob.
Another vowel?
Sorry, John, I've just spotted your pen. Why have you got a life-size penis on the top of your head?
Lads.
I'm slightly worried that if you get stuck on a bit, you know sometimes when you get, like, stuck on a...
Don't think it'll happen, mate.
Vowel.
I.
Consonant. You know
the, yeah, there we go.
K.
Another vowel, thanks.
E.
Consonant.
D.
Consonant.
C.
Consonant.
M.
And another vowel, thanks.
And the last one, O.
And so for the first time today, here's the countdown clock.
Seven.
OK, so, Bob, what have you got?
Five.
OK, Vic?
I've got 2 sixes.
12, then. OK. Sean?
I got 6.
OK, Bob, you're 5.
Miked. M-I-K-E-D.
Pretty good. OK, Vic, you're 6.
Cooked and commode.
Cooked and commode. Sean, you're 6.
Moody.
Moody with a...
Double E.
Is that a word?
No, and commode needs 2 M's as well.
Well, I'm not cooked.
You're going for cooked, weren't you?
You're cooked, OK. John, you're 7.
Cookied. I cookied a cake. Oh, no, I-E-D, as in to have eaten a cookie. I'm not a fucking idiot.
Cookied?
How would you use that? Cookie.
Someone brought in some cookies and milk, and whilst I cookied, I didn't milk.
I love it, but it's still not there, sadly.
Well, 6 points to Vic for cooked.
Well done, Vic.
Thank you. Jack, Susie, mainly Susie, could they have done any better?
I can get any better than 6. Mocked cookie, yeah.
Jack?
But I could get anyway.
You've got a very weird face.
Weird how?
A distinctive face. It's good. You could never commit a horrific crime because you get caught straight away.
No, not the case. OK, so at the end of that, Sean and Vic are in the lead with 6. On to our first numbers round. OK, Sean and Vic, your turn to pick the numbers.
To the chop, 4 from everywhere else.
4 from everywhere else. Right, the numbers are 10, 2, 6, 5, and the big one's 50 and 100. And the target, 838.
OK, and your time starts now. The target was 838. Did you get it, Bob?
No, I got 870.
Oh, OK. quite a ways away. John, did you get it?
No, I got 840.
840, go pretty close. Sean?
No, I got 835.
Vic?
I'm still adding them up.
John, how did you get 840?
100 plus 5.
100 plus 5, 105.
Multiplied by 6 plus 2.
Multiplied by 6 plus 2 for 840. Lovely.
So 7 points to John. Have you got it now?
Yeah. Matter now, though, does it?
Yeah. Matters to you. Look at your little face. Rachel, you're not bad at maths. Could you do it? Pick this one out?
Yes, this one well was possible. Thanks, Jimmy. 100 plus 50 minus 10.
Come on.
Is 140.
Yeah, I think we can all see that.
Times by 6.
Yes.
Is 840.
Fine.
And take away the 2.
I would quite like to become a courtroom artist. There, I've said it. Because you get to get paid to do drawings, which is fun, and nowadays you get to meet all the people you loved as a kid on TV.
Very good point, well made. The scores at the moment are Sean and Vic have 6, John and Bob have 7. Here is your teaser. The words are blue dong. The clue is beat it repeatedly. That's blue dong, beat it repeatedly. See you after the break. To the teaser, the words were blue dong. The clue was beat it repeatedly. It was, of course, bludgeon. So John and Bob are in the lead. OK, time to mix things up a little bit. They've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Vic and Bob. So, Vic, your turn to choose the letters.
A consonant, please.
Thank you, Vic. S.
And a vowel.
A.
And a consonant.
C.
And another consonant, for heaven's sake.
D.
Consonant.
M.
Vowel, please.
E.
Vowel.
O.
To count a consonant.
F.
And a vowel.
Sack me off. U.
Exactly what I was hoping for.
OK. And your time starts now. You dog and bitch.
You're a married man now.
Bob, what'd you get? How many?
5, thank you.
Vic?
6.
Bob, you're 5.
It's codes.
Codes.
You can't even be bothered. She can't be bothered to get off her stool. And
she's no, quite right. You were right there, Rachel. Yeah, not worth your bother. Vic.
Medusa.
Yes.
Wow.
Fantastic. It's a jellyfish.
Not the snaky woman.
No. It's a jellyfish. Brilliant. Okay. I had that.
Medusa. Could they have done any better?
You could have focused for 7.
Focused.
I'm very focused right now. Oh. Jimmy, could you take off your suit? Sorry, I'll do it in my head.
OK, so at the end of that, John and Bob have 7. Sean and Vic are in the lead with 12. OK, on to our next numbers round. Bob, your turn to choose the numbers.
I love all small ones, thanks.
You sure?
Yeah.
You sure, Bob? So it make it really hard.
Oh, well, I find it hard enough anyway.
Okay. I see.
I'm much more familiar with the smaller numbers.
We're only going up to 10, so you should be fine. 9, 8, 4, 10, another 10, and 3. and the target 674.
Okay, and your time starts now.
Jimmy, could you turn round that way and just look over your shoulder? Wait, yeah, so your body's that way, stop, and then look back over at me. Yes, perfect, just keep that look. Thank you. You look less worried, more, yeah, sultry. Nice.
John, don't move a muscle, but the pen...
Accurate, these things. So, anyway.
John, what did you get?
Jack shit.
You didn't get it?
Nope.
Okay, Bob?
I got 682.
Oh, close enough. Vic, how did you do?
Got it bang on.
Bang on. 674. Sean?
No, I got 656.
Okay, Vic, how did you do it?
Okay, 8 times 10 is 800.
It's 80.
That was me. That was my first mistake. How did you do that?
I did exactly the same.
Can I just carry on? Can I just carry on? Because I know I've got the rest of it right. Even though I've got that wrong.
80 times 10.
8 times 10 is 800, right?
Yeah. Yeah, sure.
9 times 10 is 90. Add that together. Yeah. Equals 810. Add the 4 and add the 3 and you get 817.
That is technically the worst anyone's ever done. You couldn't be more wrong in every single aspect of what you did there. Bob, how did you get 682?
Well, here goes. I think 10 times 8 equals 80, times 10 equals 800. Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
9 times 4 equals 36, times 3 equals 118.
108. Sorry.
Take that off the 700 that you previously had.
It's 800, I think, that you previously had.
You got close. Pretty close.
Did you manage to do it, Rachel?
You could have done 10 times 9 is 90, minus the 4 and minus the 3 for 83, times by 8 for 664, and add the other 10, 670. Wow.
OK, well, no points to anyone there. OK, so John and Bob have 7, Sean and Vic are in the lead with 12. OK, time to go across now to Dictionary Corner. Jack, what have you got for us? How's the sketching going?
Yeah, the sketching's going well. I have 2, the first of which I have done live and the second of which I'd prepared earlier and have just done the finishing touches to. So I'll show you. This is the first one of Jimmy. There we are. See, I've given you a 6-pack. Just to be flattering, I've given you a 6-pack.
Lovely, yeah. And my nipple there, my left nipple?
That Susie told me that. She said you had a little pierced nipple, so I popped on the pierced nipple.
Well, it's quite a smooth...
That is the correct anatomical representation of you, is it not?
Also, the way he's reclining, looks like he's in a kid's car seat. Like he's just got into someone's car and just sat there naked, waiting for them to come back from the shops like that.
None of this actually happened. It is a sketch.
Can I borrow your pen?
Oh, no. Don't do that. I'm very happy with that. Susie, I can only apologise. I realise you're one of the leading lexicographers in the country.
Do you like to see the second one?
Yeah.
The second one I prepared earlier, but I've just done the finishing touches to. This is another one of Jimmy. There we are. Peachy little tush there, eh?
Thank you very much.
Is he holding a bin bag, Jack?
Yeah, he's
been having a shit in a bin bag.
No one else saw that shot of Kim Kardashian and went, is she shitting in a bin bag? Ladies and gentlemen, Jack Whitehall, our artist in residence. Here is your teaser. The words are Vic, your tit. The clue is things could get lively. That's Vic, your tit. Things could get lively. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were Vic, your tit. The clue was things could get lively. It was, of course, activity. OK, before we go on, he doesn't actually work here anymore, but he keeps on turning up. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Joe Wilkinson. Joe, what's going on?
I'll be honest with you, Jimmy. I'm in a bit of a bad mood. Yeah, a bit pissed off, and this is what happens. Don't know why it happens, but it always does. I drink quite a lot of radioactive waste.
So, why are you in a bad mood?
You taking a piss? Fucking hell, mate. I'm in a bad mood because you fired me. That's why I ripped the door off your car. Yeah, been drinking a lot of radioactive waste. They're saying it's given me some special powers, like the old bit of the old strength. But I've got a few others as well, like I've got X-ray vision now. I can see through clothes and that. Oh, God. I can't look at you. But I've got a few others as well I can show you, special powers I've developed over the last few weeks. Fabio, do you want to come on? Remember my half-brother Fabio? Oh, yeah, I should point out, when I get angry, I go green, and when he gets confused, he goes orange.
He looks like a really fit Watsit.
But I've got quite a few new skills. Go on, fuck off. If you don't tell him, he'll just stand there. Do you remember Yuri Geller used to be able to bend spoons with his mind?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I can do the same thing with guttering. You know, that's one of my things. One of the other things I can do... You're like this, Rachel. Wherever I point, an egg cup appears. not that useful, that one. Let's play countdown!
Okay, on with the game. John and Barb, your turn to choose the letters.
Do you want a quick glass of wine, Rachel? Yeah, go on, it. Sorry, I don't have my own strength. There's none in that one.
John and Bob, go on, pick some letters.
Let's have a consonant, please.
L.
And a vowel, please.
I'll do the vowels.
Okay.
Oh, sorry.
Another consonant, please.
W.
And a vowel, please.
O.
And a consonant, please.
R.
And another consonant, please.
Just landed. I'm going to smash the place up in a minute. Come on.
Oh, please.
I.
Oh, and a consonant.
You'll have a fucking vowel, mate.
E.
Still in a bit of a mood, if I'm honest.
I'm definitely having a consonant now.
T.
Thank you.
OK, and your time starts now. How'd you do?
I haven't got anything.
OK. John, what have you got?
Six.
Six, OK. Vic?
Six.
Sean?
I think it's a six.
OK, well, let's hear your risky six.
Well, it's one of those words that is a foreign word but's used definitely in American English.
OK.
Wiener.
Yeah.
Wiener.
How are we spelling it?
Don't say that. W-I-E-N-E-R.
Excellent. Yeah, do you want all three meanings?
Yes, I would.
A small sausage.
Oh, Jimmy!
A man's penis. Or a stupid, boring or contemptible person.
Oh, my God, I'm all three! Yes! Vic, you're six.
Trowel. Oh, that's good.
Mm. Isn't it?
Good.
Yeah.
You've got a trowel.
Trowel is good. John, you're six.
Trowel.
Not so good.
OK, 6 points for both teams. Jack, Susie.
It won.
Could they have done any better?
Yep, we had winter, which is a season. Toe line.
Yeah, that's which seven, is... which is a line for towing.
Towny. Someone from a town.
I thought you'd like towny.
Or towee, which is a collection of twats.
OK, so at the end of that, Sean and Vic are in the lead with 18 points. So, Jack, you've drawn me beautifully, I might say. What are you going to work on next?
Well, I thought maybe next, if I may, I could paint Susie.
OK.
Are you up for that?
Definitely.
I'll keep it a little bit cleaner, obviously, than what I did with Jimmy, but I'd love to paint you, if that's OK.
Great.
Thank you.
No, it's an honour, I think, to be painted. One nice thing. OK, on to another numbers game. Sean and Vic, your pick of the numbers.
Two from the top, four from everywhere else.
Two from the top, four little. Number nine, number three.
Three.
One.
Yes.
Five. And then 25 and 75. And the target, 950.
OK, and your time's
coming. Could I start it back?
Now. What have you got?
I've only just finished writing them down.
Okay.
Nine times 100 is 900, right? Add 50 is 950. That's right, isn't it?
Bob, did you get it?
No, I thought I got what I was after, which was 975. I've made an error there.
Okay, Sean, what did you get?
I got 936.
You got 3 shillings, are you?
Okay, John, what did you get?
950.
Okay, how did you get 950?
9 plus 1 plus 3.
9 plus 1 plus 3, 13. 9 times by 75. 975. 975. -25. 950. 10 points to John. Okay, time to go across once again to Dictionary Corner, where Jack, I believe, is painting Susie Dent. How's that going?
Yeah.
There we are.
Lovely.
What am I?
A sort of lopsided tiger. It hasn't quite worked out.
Makes you look a lot younger.
Would you like to paint your face?
No.
Can I do one thing?
Okay.
Because I think this would be very befitting.
I'd like a Dali-esque moustache.
No, I think this. And then put on your glasses. You look like a really washed up old Harry Potter.
OK, the scores at the moment, Sean and Vic have 18, John and Bob have 23, and here is your teaser. The words are bum data, the clue is give it a tap. That's bum data, give it a tap. See you after the break. The answer to the teaser, the words were bum data. The clue was give it a tap. It was, of course, drumbeat.
Jimmy, when people tune in, they might think that Susie's lashed out at me. I'm sorry, I got the word wrong. Please don't do it again, Susie.
Okay, on with the game. Sean and Vic, your turn to choose the letters.
Go on, Vic, fill your boots.
Consonant, please.
There you go. That one's an N.
N. A vowel.
It's yours.
Consonant.
Consonant.
Doing it.
consonant.
Consonant.
A P.
Consonant.
Vowel. Vowel.
A.
Oh, another vowel.
Thank you.
E.
And your time starts now.
No genitals. That is a downside. That is a downside. Just a warning, guys. Just a warning.
Vic, how many?
Six.
Sean?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
What the hell is that?
Prairie.
John, how many?
7.
OK, and Bob?
6.
OK, Bob, what was your...
Prairie.
What?
Prairie, yes.
How are you spelling prairie?
P-R-A-I-R-E. No?
Me two eyes.
So, Sean, you had prairie also?
No!
Vic, what'd you get?
A Rione.
Oh, OK, Rione.
How are you spelling Rione?
R-H-I-O-N-E.
No.
OK, John, what is your 7?
Phonia.
Ah, that is superb.
7 points to John. Could they have done any better, Jack and Susie?
You could have had hornier.
We were hornier.
Oh, yeah. Or orphan.
OK, so at the end of that, John and Bob are in the lead with 30 points. John, how is your hen do going? Because it doesn't feel like it's been a particularly raucous stag do for you.
No, I've enjoyed it. Stag, stag, stag. Lats, 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 lats. I'm having a breakdown, Jimmy. Just want to get the conundrum.
You're having a breakdown. Look at Panda Boy. Why are you now a panda?
Well, because I went from a battered husband to being a panda. It's an easy one to make. It's just one eye in it.
Okay. Figures on buzzers, it's time for today's Countdown Conundrum. Your time starts now.
Knowingly.
Oh! Let's have a look.
John Locke.
With 30 points, John and Bob. Congratulations, you're now the proud owners of this Countdown Swing Ball set. Bob, come on up.
Great to play, Jimmy.
Yeah, sure. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.